Hi there. My name is Sebastian Straub. I'm a system engineer here at N2W, and I want to welcome you to the continuation of our configuration video for Cloud Protection Manager. As you remember, last time we created a policy which now protects Cloud Protection Manager itself. Now it's going to get to the interesting part. This is where we want to actually protect our workloads. So as you can see, my backup was successful. That's for my Cloud Protection Manager policy. Now let's create an additional policy. Once again, this is going to be my friendly name for my backup policy. I'm going to name this one web server. That's the one that I originally wanted to backup. Generations to save, I'm going to lower this in my case to 14. And I can also associate this with the already existing daily schedule. But of course, if you wanted to schedule this in different intervals, you could just simply go ahead and create a different schedule or even multiple schedules as well. I'm going to click on Apply. Now, this is essentially an empty policy. We haven't decided yet what we want to backup with this policy. So over here on the right side of the screen, that's where we have our backup targets. So if I select this, then I can choose what kind of resources I want to backup with this policy. I do have the option to backup instances plus all of the volumes that are attached to that instance. If I really wanted to, I also have the option just to backup volumes, data at rest, unattached volumes. I could also backup RDS databases, Aurora clusters, Redshift clusters, and DynamoDB tables. So in our case, we wanted to backup my web server. So I'm going to click on Add Instances. Now over here, under Choose Region, I can choose which region I want to backup from. And then I choose the server, the workload that I want to backup. In my case, that was my web server. All I have to do is just simply tick box that, click Add Selected. And as you can see that the web server is now right here behind this window. So if I close this, you can see that we're all selected, all ready to go to backup my web server using our policy. So if I go back to policies, that's really, once again, all there is to it. From now on, Cloud Protection Manager will also additionally backup my web server. But one more thing, always be on the safe side. So why not also configure disaster recovery for that as well? So once again, we'll turn this on very easy. And we're also going to create a disaster recovery backup into Ohio. Select Apply. And if we really want to try this out, we can run the policy right now with Run ASAP. And if we go to Backup Monitor and refresh this, then we'll see that the backup policy is now kicking in and also backing up my web server. So thank you very much for joining me. And in the next video, I'll show you how to actually recover the data as well.